Welcome back, everyone. We're here with Risen Strike, and he's going to be giving us a tutorial on making tile floors.
So, what we're going to be doing today is showing people how to create the ogre floor tiles. Just regular floor tiles, but you can use them for ogre builds. It's very easy and simple. So first, what we want to do is create the base before we make the tiles. So what we're going to do is we're going to create the base out of microvoxels. Take a selection, you erase it off the air. We have your voxels, now we're going to smooth it down. I guess about twice should do it for now. That's good. Now we take that microvoxel, we want to copy it. And slowly start creating a line. Okay, that's a good line that we can extend. After we have the line, now we can use the line to create a, make it wider and longer, so it's faster than just having that little dot. And this will be the top of your floor. Yeah, there you go, that's simple now. Then after you have the top of your floor where you want to create it, give it more weight to it because you want to be able to sink it into the ground. So you take this that you made and you copy it and you paste it below it. I usually do it twice so I can have a good base that I can sink in, and this is what you start with. So now to create the tiles, you'll create another microvoxel. And this is where you define how big you want your cracks to be. The size of the microvoxel would determine the size of the crack. For now, let's do it twice and see what happens. And now what you want to do is when you go in, you want to negative paste it into the floor. You can create whatever pattern you wish to create. Here we have straight line, let's cut something else. When you do that the first time, it's gonna create like triangle slant. What you do is you go back into the corner that you originally had and you go back in and negative paste in there and it'll fix it. It'll snacks right back up. Let's do the other side. So now, you can either create a pattern then it's even, like this right now, but a lot of people want to create is a look of unevenness because they don't want all the tiles to be the same. So let's cut right here and you can see what that does. And let's make another cut right here. Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how you will create your own tile flooring. Now, this is the clean look. If you are going for clean, you know, you want your structures to be like brand new or something like that, this will be the thing to do. But if you want to look more realistic, more weathered down, like people have been walking through the pavements and stuff, you wanted to give it a weather effect. And how you would do that is that you create another micro voxel, but this time either bigger or smaller than the original you had. This is the original we had right here, still up here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna smooth it one more time. Gonna copy it. What I do with that now is that I paste it, negative paste it into the cracks that I already have. And it'll shrink the crack so it looks like it's weather. I'm just gonna pull it up too. I'll just do that. I'll just put in random areas. There we go. That should be good enough. And there you have it. You'll have your floor weathered down. Looks like people have been walking in for a fair amount of time. And that's how you would do your weather floor pattern. You can copy this and paste it to make multiple, make it bigger, or you can do a huge section and do every little detail. It just depends on what you want to do.
Here's an example of the detail work Risen has done and what you can achieve by using this method. If you found this video instructive and entertaining, consider leaving a like. Thanks for watching, everyone, and be sure you're subscribed for future landmark news.